us, take us, every bit of us. That's what we're here to ask you today as we look at the gift of surrendering to you, the gift of yielding to you and your will and your presence and power in our lives. Take us, as we just said, take our intellect, take our will, take our moments and our days, take our love, Lord, and let them be for you. So Lord, renew our hearing of the word and refresh our heart this day. In your name we pray, amen. You may be seated. Well, the yield sign. How many of us know about the yield sign as we're driving along, and how many of us really do yield? And is she okay? Sue, is she okay? Okay. Okay. We had one of our, for the videotape, we had one of our little ones just run off the altar, so we hope and pray she's okay. So anyway, we talk about one of the essential principles in a life worth living is that of surrendering or yielding to God. And so we've been speaking about the goal of what every Christian life ought to be about, what your life and my life ought to be about. It's about becoming more Christ-like, becoming more like Christ, moment by moment and day by day. To live life with the courage, the compassion, the mercy, the grace, the power, the principles, the kingdom values of God in Jesus Christ. That's what we do in the journey of faith. So we're talking about yielding or surrendering. Yielding, by definition, is to give way to give up to submit to bow down to agree to comply with. Surrender, cease to resist, yield to, submit to, concede to, acquiesce, fancy word, acquiesce, or relinquish. So these two words, yield and surrender, that I'm going to use interchangeably, has to do with giving up and submitting to, giving to God our lives. So as Christians, as Christ ones, as children of God, you and I, we are to surrender, we are to yield to God. We are talking about relinquishing our control, our rights, our power, our hopes, our dreams, surrender our goals, our aspirations, our will, our way. Notice I use the word our. We're surrendering our, what we think about our lives and what our lives are about. And so we are talking about relinquishing, giving over what we are about. We are giving over to the loving God who gave us life, who gave us all that we are and about, who gave us our time, our talents, and our possessions, signs of his gracious love in our lives. Jesus himself, he lived a life yielded to his Father in heaven, surrendered to his Father in heaven. From John 6, verse 38, Jesus says, I came down from heaven not to do my own will, but the will of the one who sent me. And then from John 8, I do nothing of myself, but as the Father has taught me, I speak these things. And then, of course, in our gospel for today, we hear Jesus himself yielding to the power and the will of his Father in heaven. We have Jesus in the Garden of Gethsemane before he is arrested and goes to the cross. It's a critical moment in history, and Jesus says, if this cup cannot be taken away from me, he's praying mightily, deeply, passionately, if this cup cannot be taken away, unless I drink from it, Father, then your will be done. What surrender. not surrender. And then if we look at John 3:16, we see the ultimate, complete, and absolute surrender and yielding of God Himself to us. Think about that. God Himself yielding, surrendering to us. For God so loved the world that He gave, He surrendered, He yielded His Son, Jesus Christ, His only begotten Son, so that all those who believe in Him shall not perish, but have eternal life. Jesus is full, total, absolute surrender to the will of His Father for us, for His creation, to the Father in heaven. This is the supreme example of how we ought to live. But we don't do that so well, do we? Because we are sinners in need of God's power and strength and presence in our lives. In our surrender, we must give ourselves to God as God gave Himself, totally, unconditionally, without reservation. To acknowledge Jesus as the Lord and Savior begins the process of surrendering. So first we need to acknowledge that there is a God, that God is who He says He is. And so as we accept and receive Christ at the waters of holy baptism, as we are renewed in the waters and washed clean, the process of surrendering has begun. The accepting of His superiority over us. The accepting that He is the way, the truth, and the life. Accepting that He, His way, is the better way for our living. From Psalm 37, surrender yourself, rest, relieve yourself, release yourself to the Lord and wait patiently for Him. Surrendering your life means following God's lead without really knowing where we're going, waiting for God's timing, without really knowing when His timing will be fulfilled. Surrendering our life means expecting a miracle without knowing how and when God will provide it. Surrendering our life means trusting God's purposes without understanding what may come. And so, you and I, we know we are surrendering to God when we rely on God to work things out, letting go and letting God get down to business. Genuine surrender says, Father, if this problem, this pain, this sickness, this circumstance is needed to fulfill Your purpose and Your glory in my life or for another person's need, then please don't take it away. Father, whatever I'm going through, don't take it away if it's for my well-being or the well-being of other people. That's what surrender is about. How difficult that is, isn't it? That's a level, a spiritual level of maturity that doesn't come easily, that takes a lifetime of journeying there. In Jesus' case in the garden, He agonized so much so deeply before going to his crucifixion and death that scripture says he sweated blood. What a spiritual level of maturity we are called to do and be about. Surrendering to God all of our joys and our celebrations, all of our struggles, our pains, our difficulties, all of the challenges in our school lives, all the bullying, to surrender it all to God. As children of God, it requires intense warfare. It requires intense warfare against our self-centeredness, our self-centered nature, because we want to take possession of our destiny. We want to take possession and deal with our problems and our outcome. No thanks, God, I got it covered this time. I'll call on you later, another time. It means yielding our ownership and our possessiveness and our clutching, holding on to all that we think we own, all that we think we possess, all that we think we have in our hands. So when we surrender to God, we are deeply acknowledging that what is our life, our time, our talents, our possessions, our minds, our will, our hopes, our dreams, our aspirations, our goals, deeply acknowledging that all that we believe is our life really belongs to God, because he is the giver of it all. And so surrender is also about giving to God, yielding to God all the circumstances of our lives, the good, the bad, the ugly. Surrendering to God helps us to let go of whatever has been holding us back from God's very best in our lives. Think about that. And so we need to come to the end of ourselves, give up ourselves, give up our need to interfere with God's work in us and God's work through us. As Christians, we no longer belong to ourselves. At the waters of holy baptism, all of that changed. We no longer belong to ourselves. It is God at work in us. And so, surrendering really is about kicking ourselves out of the center of our living, our hearts, and our minds. It's getting rid of ourself out of there, because God's already in there. And so it's about kicking us out of the center of our lives, out of living for us and for ourselves, so that we are not getting upset and disappointed in what God does or does not do. It's letting God so reign in our lives that we no longer are living with the attitude that God's purpose for our living is to give us happiness and blessings and success. Surrendering is so important that we no longer live with an attitude that whatever I have done, whatever I have accomplished, I deserve. You see, we hear that a lot in 21st century advertising. We do not deserve anything. It's living, surrendering is living with the understanding that what we have, what we are about, is something that God gives us to be used for His glory, for His purposes. And so it's a shift in attitude from I to he, God, our Savior. This is what He continues to do for me, for us, through me. And so we must step aside and let God be God. We must hand over ourselves to God and what He wants to do in us to reshape us and transform us. We have to hand over, we ought to hand over ourselves to God for what He wants to do in us and through us. You can't imagine how God is using you to make a difference in your family, with your children, your grandchildren, your nieces, your nephews, if you're in the sandwich generation, your aging parents, through your own surgeries, through your own struggles, through your own pain, through your joys. God wants to work in and through us. And this result of this giving over of ourselves, of yielding ourselves, of surrendering to God, Christ will be seen in me and you, and Christ will be expressed into the world through me and you. And putting the focus of our life and our living where it belongs, on God. Our focus ought to be about God. We are giving over in love to God what He has first given us, what He has offered us in His love, by His love, for His love. And we do this all through the power and the presence of the Holy Spirit that guides us and directs us and allows us to flourish and grow and be transformed into the likeness of Christ. Sue will do the video now.
journey of faith throughout our lifetime in a transforming way by your Spirit. To yield our hearts to you, to surrender to you. Oh Lord, it's not easy. Our human nature is a selfish nature. Our human ways are selfish ways, and we want to do and be on our own. And we think we can negotiate life without you. So many try. But in the end, they are left wanting, left needing. And so, Lord, on this transforming journey, we know that a life worth living is a life lived in you. That nothing can keep us from you. Heavenly Father, help our hearts to be yielded to you, so that you are our King, our Lord, our Savior, our best friend. Heavenly Father, as we yield to you this day, we yield to you in prayer for those who are ill or hospitalized, for those who are struggling, for those who are celebrating great moments in their lives. And so we come to you in prayer and ask that you be with Bill and Carol and Deacon Chris and Kennedy and Joanna.